His videos for the Athletic Edge Nutrition Pull-Up Competition. For the first week, I did a max set for 6 days. I did 23, 26, 27, 28, 29. And on the last day, I did 28 for 2 sets, so I wasn't able to hit 30. So for this week, I'm going to do 100 for time. So I'd say if you could do about 20 pull-ups, you should be able to do 100. And then you want to do that the fastest time possible. And if you can only do 10, do 50 for the fastest time possible. And to start, I'll weigh myself first. Should be around 207. Try to do only half your max, otherwise you're going to burn out. So I'm probably going to start out at 10. And my best time is 8 minutes and 38 seconds, and this is how it's broken down. So you're going to notice that you're getting down to 2 reps at a time. And then singles. So there's about probably 20 sets here. So some tips: keep track on paper or pencil, or use one of these clickers. And since you're doing so many sets, I wouldn't normally recommend it, but gloves are good, or else you're gonna tear skin off your hands. And ways to improve your time. But probably 2 ways to improve your time would be cut down your breaks. Don't take so many or so long. And just do pull-ups. And if you can't do any more, just let go. Don't struggle or hang there and try to get one more. Just let go and then save your energy for your next set. So I'm going to start out with my first set. I'm at 0. This will be my timer in the background. Some people were commenting, well, can I just pull up and then let go off the bar? I guess you could, but that's not what you're going to be doing when you do pull up. So the best thing is just lower yourself all the way down, then let go. So far, I'm going to move this and I'll stop it. I probably could have done 6, but I'm alright. 4. Okay. 31. Trying to find that perfect gap between taking the break for a long enough one versus way too short. Okay, you're right. I'm at 39. See what I did last time. 10, 10, 6, 4, 4, 4, 4, 3, 3, 2, 4. Sometimes it goes back up. This is why I use the clicker. I don't know what rep I'm on. Okay, 46, four more under 50. That's my force. So, 4 and 4, 15 and 4 minutes, we're going to keep the same pace. It's close. Yeah, my hands have been torn up by now. Six. So, the two ways of training, in your rep range, 28, 29, wherever you're at. We're training in that small range and pushing your cardio system and your muscular endurance. And you don't want to be doing really anything different than you would normally do on a rep. So that's the only way you're going to get better. Three more and I'll be at 70. Great. 70, that's 641. Towards the end is where you want to take the shortest breaks. That's exactly what I'm talking about. You don't want to do that extra rep. Save that energy for your next set. 75. I was like, I'm gonna beat 8:38. Now, if you get to the point where you can't do any more, you're probably not ready for 100. Maybe. I couldn't do any more right now. 75 would be a good number to aim for. Eighty. 20 more to go. I might do more every second to beat it. But singles. Now you have 10 more to go. 1, 2. Five more to go. Subscribe, check out my other videos. I'll try to give you more useful tips on how to do more pull-ups. Thanks for watching.